Hello, everybody. This is Elise Benin of marketing-mentor.com. I am also the host and co-founder of the Creative Freelancer Conference, which is happening. Our sixth annual Creative Freelancer Conference is happening this June 22nd through 24th in San Francisco with as part of How Design Live. And today I am here with Sarah Horowitz, who is the founder and executive director of Freelancers Union, for a little video chat because she couldn't make it to CFC this year, but hopefully next year. Sarah, hello.
Hello, hello. Looking forward to next year.
Absolutely. So I have three questions for you, Sarah. The first one is, you know, we all know that freelancing is on the rise. And I saw somewhere that recently half of the workforce by the end of the decade is going to be freelancing. So I want you just to give us some context. Tell us what you see, what you mean when you talk about freelancing, what's coming.
Well, you know, what you can really see is this idea that people are going to work for one company in a 40-hour work week is just over. And what we're really seeing is that people are working from job to job and project to project and gigs, and work is just so much more short term, whether you call it freelancing, solo entrepreneur, self-employed, it really doesn't matter. It really is about this shorter term nature of work. And when the government has last looked at it, what they found was it's about a third of the workforce. Big companies like IBM are predicting that half of their workforce will be like this. And technology, the same, the technology sector. So this is very much the present and the future.
And you have a new book out called The Freelancer's Bible, which I've read and I love. And we've blogged about it on the Creative Freelancer blog, so people can find excerpts from it there. And okay. I know that you've been touring as part of your promotion of the book and talking to freelancers. And I'm wondering, can you tell us about the challenges that you hear them talking about and how exactly are they addressing those challenges?
Well, you know, the Freelancer's Bible, the reason I wrote it was because after all these years of really meeting with freelancers and hearing some of the biggest issues for them, it really became important to let people know you're not the only person. It's not you. It's not a shortcoming. There are universals. And so some of the really big ones for people, of course, was the work coming in, coming out, sort of the what we've called the feast or famine nature of freelancing, the fact that freelancers very typically do not get paid, and that this really does happen, and it has happened to everybody, and also to incorporate or not incorporate. And I think my favorite and the thing I think I learned the most was really how to be strategic about looking at your work when you're working independently, and to really separate into piles those jobs and gigs that are recurring every month. They're your blue chips. They're, you can rely on them. Mm-hmm. And all the way on the other spectrum are the ones that are sort of your R&D, where you see your professional field going or your personal interests, and that you're going to take time during each week to learn, grow, network your way into your new fields, and then what comes in between. And really trying to be strategic about that. And I think that was one of the biggest and most important things I think I learned in writing the book.
And what about, how are people coming together? I know we hear a lot more about co-working spaces. What kinds of things are happening out there so that people can help each other?
You know, I think another thing that is just so clear, you know, when I started writing the book or talking in general, it became so clear that successful freelancers, and when I mean successful, I don't mean top earners. I really mean people who have a three-dimensional life, have a really robust network. But I'm actually starting to think about it even more broadly in terms of biodiversity and sustainability, and that really it's about people who develop relationships. They have mentors. They're in organizations. They have people to meet with. They're real givers, and they're also getters, because if you give and take, it's like a rhythm. And that you start to understand your own rhythm and you get the specifics in that. So in other words, you say, these are my blue chips and this is my income that comes in. This is what I want to learn. These are the people I need to sort of learn from. I have to be sure that I'm mentoring and giving back because others are on the same kind of parallel road, and that you're realizing we're all in this together. And I think that is so important. It's a mindset. It's very different than the kind of career track of, you know, 30 and 40 years ago.
And it seems like there's a very proactive aspect to this mindset too. Like, I have to figure out what I need and then I have to go get it, as opposed to, you know, the job is just going to give me anything it wants to and I have to take it.
I think, Elise, it's kind of what you're known for in terms of talking about being proactive as opposed to passive, saying that, as you said, you know, thinking of yourself as a small business owner and realizing you've got to make it happen. And I think that when you talk about it, you actually mean it in a really beautiful way of how to make your life meaningful and to achieve the things that you want to achieve, and really thinking about what do you need to do, really from soup to nuts, from small to big, and then finding out what are you good at, what are you not good at. If you don't have to do your taxes. There are tax preparers out there. You don't have to be good at marketing. You can find some great marketing tips or partner with people or co-working. I don't want to be in my house, but I can't afford just to have my own office. There are just a lot of new kinds of resources out there for freelancers, but it's not going to happen to you passively. You've got to get out there.
Absolutely. So last question. Let's jump ahead 20 years. Right? If we look back, what are we going to see? Like, what is this shift that we're going through? What are the biggest opportunities?
You know, I think that's a great question, and it leads to my complete favorite quote of all time, which is, the future is here. It's just not evenly distributed. And I think that what we're already seeing is that so many of our institutions are just so completely changing. But the good news for freelancers is they're the avant-garde. And so what I think we're going to see, number one, is that this is either a problem or an opportunity, depending on really how you deal with it. We're not going to have as much work as we had before, which means we're going to have to figure out what is our new enough. And I think that's going to be important, really figuring out what you need, why you need it, and planning to really simplify your life. Then really thinking about the things that you love to do and recognizing that there are many elements of your work in a week, and that you can really consciously plan for that. And some of it is, you've got to earn a living, and you have to pay the rent, and that's just reality. But you're also entitled to do the things you love, and to try and find, how do you do as much of that as possible? And I think that's really the zeitgeist of the moment that we're in.
Now, I know that you are speaking about this all over the place and writing about it, so let's give people some links where they can find more about you. I know that the Freelancers Union, freelancersunion.org, is a place where they can sign up to be members of the Freelancers Union, and it's free, so they absolutely should.
And I also get access to all sorts of benefits like life, dental, and disability, and also other kinds of other regular benefits that you need, and it's free, actually.
And the things a lot of people don't want to be thinking about in the first place, right, that the Freelancer
Yes.
Union is offering. And also, your new blog, Dispatches, tell us about that and where to find it.
Well, you can find it at freelancersunion.org/dispatches. And what I decided to do was to try and write about all the great and interesting people that I get to meet with as I build Freelancers Union, all the great freelancers, people who are thinking about that 2025 and what's it going to look like, the people who are doing amazing things right now that we can learn from and try to see how do we shape our advocacy agenda, how do we live in this sustainable way, but really from the perspective of the people who work, the freelancers and independent workers. And so really trying to start a discussion about those topics, sharing, co-working, cooperatives, mutual aid societies, and the future.
Beautiful. Thank you so much, Sarah, for taking some time for me today.
Oh, my pleasure. Thank you.
We'll see you soon.